Hello all, it is Dr. Alsip, and I am super excited because it is time to get into some more complex osteology. Yay! We will also spend some time reviewing some structures, so these will be some nice opportunities to review what you know and what areas we need to spend a bit more time on. So we have a bit to get through, so let's not waste any more time. So this is a lateral view of the cranium. This is anterior, and this will be posterior back here. Let's finally talk about this huge hole inside of the head. We've been looking at it and kind of avoiding talking about it, so now it is time to begin discussing the external acoustic meatus, or really the external acoustic opening, but usually we just refer to it as the external acoustic meatus, and this is going to be associated with the external ear. This tunnel will lead to the tympanic membrane, and once medial to the tympanic membrane, you are in the middle ear. The external acoustic meatus will also be one of the superior boundaries of the parotid fossa. The next two structures are a review, so take a moment on your own to identify the mastoid and styloid processes. Pause the video if you need a minute to work through these. And if you have already determined, I am here to tell you good job. And now let's review together. The mastoid process is going to be posterior inferior to the external acoustic meatus, so very closely associated with it. You can feel it when you palpate under your own ear, and it will be one of the posterior borders of the parotid fossa. The styloid process is going to be much more slender, more stylus-like projection, and is anterior medial to the mastoid process. This is going to be an attachment site for many, many muscles as well as ligaments. The last thing I want you to identify in this view is the zygomatic process of the temporal bone. And the zygomatic process is going to form the majority of the zygomatic arch, this whole area is the zygomatic arch, and it will also include the temporal process of the zygomatic bone. Now, looking at an inferior view of the cranium, let's first start with a muscle attachment site, which is going to be the mastoid notch, which is going to be located right there. It's going to be a deep groove medial to the mastoid process. You can see the mastoid process right here. And this is an attachment site for the posterior belly of the digastric muscle. Moving anteriorly and very near that zygomatic process of the temporal bone, there is a notable fossa. And you can see this over here. It's also a very smooth area. Getting a little into that styloid process right there. This is going to be your mandibular fossa. The mandibular fossa is going to be the temporal portion of the temporomandibular joint. Now, just posterior to the mandibular fossa, there is going to be a slit-like fissure referred to as the petrotympanic fissure. It is through this fissure that the chorda tympani will exit the skull. So anything just posterior to the mandibular fossa will be the petrotympanic fissure. Lastly for this view, between the mastoid and styloid processes, you will see the tiniest a pinprick foramina. It literally looks like a pinprick. It is that small. This is the stylomastoid foramen. And that name makes total sense. It's between the mastoid process and the styloid process, so the stylomastoid foramen, which is where the bulk of the facial nerve will exit the skull. Speaking of super tiny foramina, let's find another one, but we are going to find this one a little easier from this inferior lateral view. So we are trying to find the tympanic canaliculus, so a really fun long name, which is how preganglionic fibers from the glossopharyngeal nerve will re-enter the skull to get into the middle ear region as the tympanic nerve. So to find this structure, I look for two easier to locate structures. The first is the external opening of the carotid canal, and the second is going to be the jugular foramen. So hopefully those are two structures that you are pretty familiar with at this point. And right in between these two structures is another foramen about the size of a pinprick, and that is the tympanic cannuliculus. All right, so I told you a little bit more difficult osteology here, but I think we're doing a good job here. Now, looking at a superior view of the basic cranium, let's understand where to locate two other structures that I would classify as on the more difficult side, structures to identify. These are the grooves for the petrosal nerves. The groove for the lesser petrosal nerve is going to be right around this region here. And it is ever so slight of a groove. It looks like it is heading towards the foramen ovale, which makes sense because that is how the lesser petrosal nerve will exit the skull. So it's a groove kind of leading towards the foramen ovale. Whereas the groove for the greater petrosal nerve is supposedly a little bit deeper and more obvious, but not too much so. It looks like it is heading for the foramen lacerum, which is right about here in this region. So this one is going to be the groove for the lesser petrosal. This will be the groove for the greater petrosal. Lastly, let's locate a few things on the mandible. The angle of the mandible is where the ramus meets the body at the base. So it's this posterior inferiormost portion of the mandible. It is a very easily palpable structure. You can try to locate it on yourself. Recall that the ramus of the mandible is going to be the vertical portion of the mandible, and its posteriormost projection is the condylar process. And this top portion right here is the condyle, or mandibular condyle, which will be the mandibular portion of the temporomandibular joint, or your TMJ. So those are the osteological structures you need to identify for this session. Please reach out with any questions, and thank you for your attention.